right now working on it, so it's fine.
Yes.
No other question would follow. So there are numerous answers that you can give. ये तो अभी सोच के बताया आपको, but yes, there are many answers that you can give. So yes, with that we come to the end of today's HR feedback session, and we will start with the technical feedback session. Okay, so.
Okay. Yeah, so we'll start with our technical feedback session today. Let's start.
Hi Rajat, let's start with the technical round. Yes. So first question from my side will be, what are different types of defects?
What are different type of defects? Okay, there are four types of defects. The one is duplicate defect, that is not a defect, considered as a defect. The another one is rejected, which is also a not defect and rejected by the developer. The third one is deferred defect, that is fixed in the later builds.
So it was we had discussed this question in the last time also, right? Deferred defect. So see, the first level when you were answering your HR questions, at the first the confidence level was at top, you can say 100%, and in the later stages it was absolutely coming down and down. So you can see here you have 50%, I can say, right? Where you know the answer and you are at the point as well. But what happened? Lack of confidence. Right? And after that also, when you had a lack of confidence as well, you were not able to specify what is not a defect or what is a rejected defect. You were just specifying the defects. Just give one line, simple and sweet, just a line, that a rejected defect is when it was not defined in the scope, or it's not a defect. It is also called the rejected. And it can be duplicate as well. Duplicate means if there are two persons logging the same defect, we can say it's a duplicate defect. So only one can be considered and the other one can be rejected. Right. So there won't be another question from the interviewer now, tell me what is, explain me in brief. Because he came to know that you know the statuses as well as it's working, or that why the status has been there. Okay.
And the
testing comes on, testing types comes under functional testing.
Functional testing, sir, functional is testing means how the, what is the behavior of the application or a software, how the feature will work. So it comes, there are certain testings which comes under.
So mainly what is functional testing? Testing the flow of the system, how the flow is working, right? As you correctly mentioned, the structure or how the flow has been from one module to another module, that is the overall flow that we test in functional testing. And what are the types of functional testing? It can be unit testing, integration testing, system testing, black box testing, white box testing. Whichever are not into non-functional testing can be considered into a functional testing.
Okay. Functional testing, like error handling.
And so you're moving into Java. So we don't have any kind of error testing in Java, okay? We have functional in functional, we have unit testing, integration testing, black box, white box, smoke testing, globalization, internalization. This all comes under your functional testing. Okay, we don't have any kind of an error handling kind of thing. It comes into our Java kind of thing, okay? So when you tell these kind of things.
Yeah. Actually, I covered the features of the functional testing.
Yes.
And I got confused that unit testing and these testings comes under the
types
functional testing, right? Or that dynamic testing.
Yeah, so dynamic testing comes under, or the validation technique, dynamic testing comes under functional only, right?
Right.
It's a functional type of testing only, right?
Comes under the
your last interview was a bit better than this, because you here tried to explore a lot, okay, and got confused a lot.
Yes.
When you explore, take out the main points only. If you read a lot, you will get confused a lot, because some terminologies, if you go to YouTube or if you go to Google, same terminologies, just there's a lot of difference between each and every descriptions of each and every testing types. So it might get confused. So try to just pick up the keywords from it and try to brief, understand in your own words, rather than just going and reading n number of things. Read only specific things and try to get, try to understand it. Then you won't get confused. Okay.
Functional test.
So, do you aware about negative testing?
No, sir.
This is very much important. Okay. Negative testing is like testing the behavior of the software with invalid or invalid conditions to check how the software is behaving.
Okay.
And in real world, if they ask you how many, what are the test cases, what is the ratio of the test cases you have written? This is a common question. Okay, the test cases you have written, what is the percentage of positive and negative? So it is always 30% positive, 70% negative. And here you said that you don't know negative testing, right? So in that case, you will not be selected. Because in company, they want 70% of the negative testing and you don't know negative testing. Negative testing is what? Just testing with your invalid inputs. What is the outcome or what is the proper error message as shown on it?
Okay.
That is your testing. That is called as a negative testing. Okay. In various conditions, how your software is reacting with negative inputs. Now, negative input doesn't mean that you are giving negative values. Negative input means which is invalid. Okay. And positive means whichever flow, like suppose if I enter a valid username and valid password and click a login button, homepage should be displayed. This is a positive test.
Yes.
Negative, entering the email address but doesn't enter any password and clicking on login, I should get that please enter a password. Or that field should be highlighted.
Yes, sir.
That should be my negative test. Okay.
Okay. So tell me, what is difference between load and stress testing?
So what is load and stress testing comes under which type of testing?
Non-functional.
Very good. So it is non-functional testing. So now you know, right? What is load and stress?
Yes. No, sir.
No?
No, sir.
Okay. So load is like giving us particular, say there are n number of users can log in at the same time. So we just check with the n number of users simultaneously working on that application. So for a specific period of load, how the system is reacting. That is a load test. Okay. Stress is like testing with a specified number of users for a certain number of time with the high number of functionality. Like checking each and everything with n number of users as well for a particular elongated period of time.
Okay.
That is called as a stress test.
Got it, sir.
Okay. We can manage stress for a particular time only, right? If I keep bundling on you n number of, say for n number of days, I am bundling n number of tasks. One day you will get frustrated and say, I am not going to do this.
Yes.
So the same way, we are just testing the system with n number of inputs for the elongated period of time to check how it is behaving. For 1 hour, 2 hours, it will behave very nicely. But at the third hour, maybe it will behave very harshly. It will not be, the site will not be available. Right?
Yes.
So to just test that, we use stress.
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware about it.
So now from here, your confidence level is directly zero.
Yes.
So now the interviewer will play very well with you. Now he knows now your confidence level is low. Now, even if you know the answers, he will try to Google. He will ask you, is it true? Is it so? So you will get confused and say, I think so. So where again you will lose your confidence. So never show that you are losing your confidence. Interview will play with you very harshly. And you will come to know and you will be like, just end up. You will be there to just end up the interview. You will be back of it. Ki, ha, I don't know. Okay, fine. And you will just give one. If you have a brief introduction of you, have a brief answers as well. You will just explain just one or two lines and you will just end up. Because your confidence level is low and you know now, बोलते हैं ना दुखती नस इंटरव्यू ने पकड़ लिया तुम्हें पता है और तुम बस के हाँ चल खत्म करो बस ठीक है डोंट डू दैट
ओके नो वरीज हैव यू यूज एनी ऑटोमेशन टूल व्हाइल डूइंग टेस्टिंग
नॉट येट
ओके
सी यू आर जस्ट गिविंग अप नो आई हैव नॉट यूज्ड प्लीज डोंट आस्क मी Right? Please don't ask me. I have not done this.
Tell me how good you are in object-oriented concepts.
How good? That means there are four pillars.
No, means I am asking, are you aware about object-oriented concepts?
So be attentive. Listen to the question what he is asking. Do you know object-oriented programming or not? Yeah, I know object-oriented programming. I have learned and I know very well, like that you can say. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, tell me what is inheritance?
Sir, inheritance is a mechanism of acquiring the properties and functionality and behavior of parent class to the child class. So there are five inheritance which is supported in Java. First one is single inheritance, multi-level inheritance, hierarchical, multiple, and hybrid inheritance.
Do we support multi-level?
Okay.
Yes, sir. Using interface. Yes, sir.
And what about multiple? Inheritance.
Yeah, yes.
Ambiguity किसमें आएगा? उसमें आएगा ना? When it is inheriting class A and B and C, C is the child class of A and B.
Yes, sir.
So what? It becomes ambiguity, right? Because he will not know. Suppose if the class A has the same members and class B has the same functions, for example. So my class C. When it is he inheriting both the classes, how he will know that which members to be inherited from A and B? So in that case, it will be ambiguity. So that was Amol sir was asking you for.
Can we implement multiple inheritance in Java?
Sir, we can implement using the interface.
We cannot. Java doesn't support it because there will be an ambiguity issue. He will not be able to access the members or he will not be able to know which members to access from A and which other members to access from B. So it will be ambiguity, right? If there are with so, the same function name. Yeah.
So there are only four types of the inheritance.
There are, but Java doesn't support multiple.
Okay.
In C and CPP, if you go, they will support. But in Java, we don't support. And if you get confused now, don't give the interviewer to ask this. Directly say that inheritance is so and so. No need to go into detail with the types. And if he is interested of he is knowing, then he will ask you as well. Because when you say multiple, multi-level, this question came about, then you should know this. So they asked you about the ambiguity. Otherwise, if I would be an interviewer, I would have never asked you about the ambiguity error or the ambiguity. Okay. So if you are sure with those types very well, then say it so that if they ask you also any further questions on it, you will be aware of it.
Yes.
And if we try to implement by like normal method, then what will be the difficulties?
See, now he's asking about the ambiguity. Sorry.
Multiple.
And that it is not supported. So Rajat, there is an e-commerce site And suppose I said you like list down all the non-functional testing scenarios. So how you will list all non-functional scenarios?
So now here what he was asking. So how you will test the performance of the system?
So performance load stress.
Yes, yes. So so how you will test it for an e-commerce site?
You told me about earlier about the load and the stress one. So by giving the multiple inputs, first the load one, for the load testing, I'll put n numbers of inputs to check whether it is working according to the requirement or not.
Just so like responsiveness also we will check, right? How it is responsive. So in the inspect element is a tool. F12, when we press, we get an inspect.
Yes, sir.
So there we can easily get the number of how many milliseconds or seconds it has been took. So from there also we can do, okay? So now here, he was expecting, when you're saying n number, I'll check with n number of inputs. Now the interview asked me that, suppose n number means 1,000. So how you will create 1,000 users? Have you used to create any 1,000 users? You got confused there also. So I said, of course, there's a tool, performance tools we have, from which we can create n number of users, dummy n number of users, who can interact with the software and who can play, we can play with those users to check its functionality, its performance of the system. So we have JMeter, we have more performance tools, which are used to create n number of users simultaneously. Okay.
Yes. Non-functional usability test
means how non-functional scenarios. Scenarios. Website. How you will ensure that like testing is enough.
So now he is asking, how you will ensure that your testing is enough? Means what exit criteria is? What would be your exit criteria or to when you will be stopping your testing? When you can stop? When you can say that, okay, my testing is done?
If a software got 90% or 90-95% bug free, then you can stop.
So how do you know that it is 95% bug free? By testing your test cases, right? By executing the number of test cases. When you're testing the test cases only, when you're running, you come to know that it is failing. Means what? There's a bug. You don't do randomly, right? You have test cases, you test all of them. When you test it, you get the outcomes. Right. If you have not tested, how you can say you are 95%, your software is 95% or 90% bug free? With the help of test cases, you can say, no, I have run this many test cases, means I have covered this many modules where I can say that there are no bugs in these modules.
Yes.
So when you can stop, there are n number of criteria. First is your number of test cases, the number that you have said, those have been passed. So your modules have been tested well. There are no high, medium, with priority and severity bugs present in your software. When the time is in crunch, your deadlines have been matched, that time you will have that, okay, now I can stop.
Yes.
These are the criteria which you have to consider when you are actually stopping the testing.
There is 80% or 90% bug free, because...
So never say this 80 or 90%, because now again the question will come, how?
Right. A software which is completely
100% bug free. Is there any checkpoints or is there any criteria?
See, he's asking the same. Right?
Yes, this is criteria. So, no worries. Going, I am done for my
solution. So, what would be your five scenarios? Say, if at all you have given any desktop application. So what would be your five scenarios? So desktop application, What are the desktop application? Excel, right? Word. You took an example of Word, for example. So what would be your topmost use cases that you will check to open a blank file? It is opening or not, right? I enter something. If I try to save, it's saving or not. I use a save as functionality. I'll close it. I'll again open in the edit mode. I'm able to edit the existing one or not. It is open and I'm trying to insert in the main. So what happens? I am writing in between and I close it. Does it show me a pop-up to close, save and close or what?
Save. Yes.
Immediately, I am working on a PC, okay? I don't have UPS. Immediately, my light is off. What happens? Whatever things I have written, does it get auto-save? Or it will be directly gone? Whatever the changes are there, it has gone. Right? Say, I'm running n number of documents simultaneously and my PC got hanged. So what is that? I close, there are n number of fields that are open, say Word documents, n number of Word documents are open. I'm closing all of them at the same time. What happens? How is the responsiveness of the system? These are the things, these are the testing scenarios.
Yes, sir.
Right? Or application.
Okay, your login system. So like you gave me an example.
Yeah.
Checking
First of all, here also you are saying about login functionality. So in desktop application, do we have login functionality?
No, sir.
See? So immediately, if at all the interviewer is going to select you also, but just by your one, you have very good command also, okay? You have good confidence level. But when you say, think over it, desktop application will never have login functionality. If I would be interviewer, I would have not selected.
Actually, sir, I'm confused with this desktop and web application. Yes, I don't have any examples.
Yeah. So when I gave you example, Excel, okay? So you took an example of Word.
Yes.
Both doesn't have
both
any.
Are same.
Both are same actually. But still you took an example. But still after taking your own example also, you are not able to say.
Actually, sir, I never like when I was watching the YouTube videos and I'm doing that course. So in that course, they just took a OpenCart website.
They will not.
Yeah, so they will the not whole take. Thing which I
see,
learned.
If at all, they would be that perfect. Or if you can, they can, you can test all of them with 2 or 3 hours, then we have wasted 1 month. Yes. Okay, it was 1 month we have done only manual testing. Say everything was available on YouTube. Nobody have joined Downtown Coders, right?
Right.
So they also have a particular thing because they have to cover everything in 2 to 3 hours. So they can just brief you about what is testing or how it should be done, but they cannot brief you in depth in each and every concept in depth. They cannot do that. They don't have that much of time as well. So they are just winding, they are in a hurry to just wind up your overall just basic concepts. They cannot go into depth. Why I am doing, because I know I have a knowledge about say 7 years or 8 years in experience in IT. So I know what are the depth that can be asked. So we are here to take a desktop application, normal scenarios and the advanced as well. Yeah. So in YouTube, I can write and give you, cannot be professional by just learning on YouTube.
So that's why I don't able to understand the ways like in which I have to test the web application and that desktop application. That is the
so now at least you know, right? Desktop application, Excel. So you might have worked on Excel also.
Yes.
But immediately you will not be able to get those things. In Excel, you will check with the n number of sheets also, n number of columns, n number of rows if you're going down and all. So what happens if I delete multiple rows at the same time? What happens if I merge? There are a lot of functionality in Excel.
Yes.
Lots and lots of functionalities. And now I have not asked you to write the test cases also. I've not asked you the attributes of the test cases also. Because many times they ask about attributes as well. And many fail in the attributes to explain the attributes of test cases.
Even I also don't know, sir.
Yeah, we will go through in the next sessions also. So I'll tell you what are the attributes to do.
Or incorrect password or right.
So see, incorrect password.
Put the...
Tell me some scenarios that you will use to test the severity and priority. So what would be severity and priority?
Severity, priority. So priority is the like, order of the sequence in which the bugs need to be fixed.
Mm-hmm.
And the severity is the, like how much the bug is impacting on the application.
Right. Right. So we test. So you have to tell me some scenarios like high priority, high severity, medium priority, medium severity, low priority, low severity.
Okay, that is the question.
Yeah. So can you just tell me one that is high priority, high severity?
Sir, in which application?
Say online site.
Online site. The high functionality, high severity. Like the close button is not working.
Close button off.
When we are like closing the online site, the close button is not working.
Okay, fine. So you know it, right? So you have to tell this. So this was the question over here, okay?
Yes.
Give me combinations of severity and priority with respect to desktop application. So now I asked you about desktop application, severity and priority. So in desktop application, what do you think the severity and priority? High severity, high priority, you are not able to open that file.
Yes, sir.
Right. You're not able to save. High priority, high severity. Sometimes I'm able to save, sometimes I'm not able to save. Medium severity, medium priority. Low severity, low priority. I cannot give a name more than 50 characters. There was no restriction, but it is more than 50 characters I'm not able to save. So very rare people will give 50 characters in a file name, right? So it is low priority, low severity. Or after three dots, the fourth dot has not been accepted. Or say not dot hyphens, like Rajat hyphen man hyphen Govind hyphen Shubdeep hyphen. Now if I give one more hyphen, then it is not working. So it is low priority. Okay.
Yes, sir.
According to the bugs that you have found on it. So you have found some of the bugs. So tell me what kind of bugs you will consider those as, say, for example, high priority, high severity, or you will, so according to
the Gmail account. So can you give me an example?
Okay, take an Excel sheet.
So, because it's the main enter button is high and the priority is is low and severity is low.
Really?
That's what I think. So.
See, so we know that you have lost your confidence. So what we asked, is it? So what you said? I think so. Right? Okay, fine. So, so what is cross-browser testing?
Yes, sir.
Cross-browser testing. So now, the confidence is negative, okay?
Yes, sir.
Cross-browser testing?
Like we are testing across the browsers.
Very good.
Never heard about this.
Compatibility testing? Compatibility?
still don't know.
Testing the application with various browsers as with various platforms. What are the platforms?
Like Windows, Mac, Linux.
Very good. Gorilla testing?
Awesome.
Gorilla testing? You did homework, dear.
Yes, sir. Not this technical one.
Okay, fine. So Gorilla testing is testing the application in depth. For example, if you're taking the, say, home page of a Flipkart application, so you will test that home page just not by navigating. I will add some of the items in the cart. I'll add some of the, from suppose if I am the, purchaser, or if I am the person who is going to add the items so that the users can view it. So I'm able to add or delete, or existing, I can update or not. So this kind of functionality, testing a functionality in depth is known as a Gorilla test. Monkey testing, what? Testing random.
Yes, sir.
Right. So in Gorilla testing, what we do, we are testing the each module in depth. Yeah. That is a Gorilla test.
Fine. Not an issue.
Okay, fine. Not an issue. So tell me, say I have assigned you a bug.
Okay.
Okay. So what would be your perspective to test it?
First one, I'll check whether this is a which kind of a bug that is. It is a duplicate, rejected, or a...
See, what went wrong here? You didn't heard the question. I said I have given you the bug for retesting. So what would be your approach for doing that? So what you're saying, I'll test that it is a duplicate or not. Of course, it was not duplicate, so it has been assigned to you for retesting. When it has been fixed, after fixing, it has been assigning, right, for retest. So we're talking about that state, not the first stage. So what would be your approach? I'll try to see, I'll test the same functionality, what is breaking. I'll just check it is breaking, it has been fixed or not. And I'll try to just do a sanity round overall to just check that it is not impacting any kind of functionality. Then, simple.
Deferred bug.
Okay, for testing purpose. So, been fixed, I have given you a bug. What kind of testings you will be doing on it? From my side, tell me, you might have done some, some product you might have been worked on, right? So, what kind of difficulties you have faced in logging the bug? Or what kind of things you think that that should be improved in case of? So what was this question about?
I don't understand.
So this was the question about what are the difficulties that you have faced in logging the bugs first? And do you think there is any modifications that has been required in the existing bug lifecycle, according to you? So first of all, when they're asking that, do you have any faced any kind of an issues? So you should always say that a tester, because we are finding out the defects, there is some faults in the softwares. So communication and writing, communication is the best, communication is a key to add the bugs and get it added. So according to me, I have a communication, good communication skills. So I have communicated with all of the stakeholders, and I have never faced any kind of an issues while adding any kind of bugs. We have a good healthy environment here. So we all are here for our best quality, to improve our quality of the product. So I didn't face any kind of issues. Okay. The second, in bug lifecycle, if you have to have any kind of modifications, so you can say from my side, I don't think there is any kind of modification required, because all of the statuses that we have, they are more clear and everything. You can also say that, for example, if there are bugs, then we should have some kind of tracking tool or tracking things where we can check what is the exact root cause, and we can add the test cases for the, if we don't have any kind of test cases for this, we can add it. So there should be some tracking tool or something like that, which we are currently not following, you can see. Okay, like that you can say, and you can end up.
Okay. In our defect life,
things from n number of, you have learned some kind of that, or what should, okay.
One of us.
Sir, I'd like to ask you, like,
see how many time you took a pause.
Yes, sir.
He was asking, do you have any questions? You have to think. Should I ask?
I'm not aware and about the question which the I should have to ask.
Okay.
So, what are the problems you face? There is a lot of politics in the IT industry, so I want to ask that. What are the things?
Yeah, sir. This is the thing which I am thinking whether I should ask or not.
Right.
The politics word is negative word.
It's an extremely negative word. You should never ask in time of interview politics and all. Ask how was your journey in the company? How many years are you working in the company?
Yeah.
When you were a fresher, how did you manage to get your first job? So you should try to, there are so many questions that you can ask. You came to a point where you are asking about the different politics in the industry.
Yeah.
And that too, it was a repo building. If the interview is very good also, and if you ask this kind of question, it will totally impact in a negative way.
Right.
Okay.
So had you given a very good technical or HR interview, this question would have rejected you straight away. So anyways, I think you are now right now aware that exactly what were required to be asked.
Yes, sir.
I think this was the only thing.
Yeah, this was there. You can stop sharing.
It was a big challenge.
Yeah.
Once you entered the IT industry, right. So, Rajat, is the feedback session helping you in any way?
Yes, sir. A lot.
So, what are the things that you are thinking that at the moment, that this is happening good or this is happening bad?
Sir, the first is my confidence level is down when new question is asked.
Mm-hmm.
So, I have to change that thing. And also the technical thing is little low, learning part. I have to learn a lot in technical also, because
right.
I'm not aware of many things.
Right. So are you, how many hours you are studying at the moment?
Presently 8 to 9,
8 to 9 hours,
Selenium and on coding.
Very good. Continue doing the same. Okay, you are on the right track. You just need to keep on doing the things, learning the things, coordinate with Govind sir. Since you have missed the manual testing part with us, right? You have only joined for automation. So many concepts of manual testing, you need to be aware of. So we will help you on that. So don't worry. Govind sir is very helpful, as you know. So you can check with him. You can sit with him and you can get all your doubts cleared over there. And you're in the right track. Just keep working hard. The opportunities are slowly going to come. Okay, we are going to roll out the opportunities for you very soon. So the more hard work you do, the better you will become each and every day. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yeah,
having said
suggest,
that, yes,
no.
Govind, yes.
Yeah, so I'll just suggest that, first of all, rather than going into automation, first build up your rapport with your manual concepts much.
Yes.
That sheet that I have shared yesterday, I'll share you the PDF as well by today UD. So you can, till that period of time, just go through the, there are n number of questions, and
yes,
those are the maximum that can be asked. So if you go towards that, there will be 80 to 90% of the questions that will be from that sheet itself. Just go through that. If you have any kind of difficulties that you face in understanding that, just let me know. We will discuss over those as well. So first of all, if you have a good manual skills, I can write and give you, you can do automation very well. Yes. In current company also, it is like 30 to 70%. 70% is manual, 30% is automation. So if you are doing very good in automation as well, you have to manage with manual as well, right? 70%.
Yes.
So you have to first focus on your manual concepts and then you can move into your automation. And I know you can do good in automation. You have those skills. You're lacking in only manual much. Okay. So first build your basics and then we can move ahead. Okay.
Yeah. So manual is just the ABCD. Okay. If you don't know ABCD, you won't be able to construct sentences. So focus on the manual things and then build your automation skills. So you won't face much problem. So don't worry. Okay. Don't be stressed and don't be unhappy that I'm not able to do. Everyone goes through this phase. So when I also started coding at that time, I also used to fail a lot. Okay. Outputs never used to come. The concepts used to go above my head, but slowly and slowly things fell into their place. Okay. So for you also, it will happen. So don't get demotivated. And as I mentioned, stick to the plan. Okay. Stick to the roadmap that we have created for you and it will definitely work. Okay. Believe in that. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So having said that, thank you for joining once again and we'll meet thank in the machine round. It will be day after tomorrow, I guess. So work hard. Yeah, it's on Thursday. Chalo, bye everyone. Thank you, Govind, for joining.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you all.